Isn't the word space an amazing topic? Some of you find it confusing, but within most of us invokes but curiosity.
From my childhood, whenever I look up to the sky, I always think, what will happen when we go up there? What will happen when we become the multi-planetary species? These questions always excited me, and I'm sure many of you did the same. That's why I'm here. I love to explore space science and technology. More specifically, I love to build the next generation of launch vehicles. My journey started when I was 6. I always tried to solve problem innovatively. I found an aerospace startup called Aeronautical Space Technology Rocketry Organization, better known as ASTRO. With that, I also filed my first patent known as a vacuum suit, a device that sucked the dust particles from floor. And the beauty of that device is that it just cost around 500 Indian rupees.
So before I tell you more about what the space industry is all about, what exactly I'm trying to do, just take a moment and imagine a day when the whole world is connected. When we can easily send a payload into space, when we can even predicting weather monsoon advance, when even we discover life on another planet, where even humanity become the multi-planetary species.
This is my vision for the new era of aerospace. I had one goal in my mind, that to make space so simple that even people like you and me can afford to send our payload into space, that humanity become the multi-planetary species. And that is my vision for the new era of aerospace. And with that, I have found four gaps in this field, in this space business field. Number one, it's not affordable. Number two, it's not simple. Number three, it's not safe. And number four, it's really important, it's not enjoyable. With that mindset, I started working on projects like Project Genesis, Project MySpace, Project Air, and some more still in the initial stage. My mission is to build the next generation of launch vehicles for launching the new generation of various categories of small satellites. When I'm saying small satellites, it's not just the cube satellites that I'm referring to. I'm talking about all those satellites that come in under the small satellites categories. Like this image shows that small satellites come in different shape and size. Let's see the graph of small satellites, how it's increasing rapidly. And same thing happening with the small launch vehicles. It's really increasing. Now the question is that, why explore space? When lots of problems here on Earth, then why we exploring, when why we putting our time, money and effort to explore space? I think exploration is a part of our DNA. That's how and why we always want to know more. Exploring space, to me, it seems like the most natural thing in the world to do. Continuously discovering of planets, moons, stars have been made in the past.
Not just the government bodies doing the same things. Now many private companies are exploring space right now. Like we all heard about the Elon Musk and his company SpaceX working on reusable rocket like Falcon 9, Falcon Heavy, and now on BFR. Similarly, like this two billionaire genius, Richard Branson, working suborbital launch vehicles. And here, Jeff Bezos, the founder and the CEO of Blue Origin, working on the what you call the reusable, also working on reusable launch vehicles. This billionaire genius trying to open space for tourism. The enthusiasm now extend to the schools and colleges, schools and colleges with the students experiment flying satellites into space.
Now the as I told you that why explore space, why we putting our time, money and effort to explore space. So how many of you really interested in exploring? How many of you really interested in environment, transportation, medicine, emergency response? All these fields rely day in and day out through space exploration. And I just want to tell you one thing. There's as we all know that the scene in 60s and 70s, the internet is only for the government and the private industries, for the government and the defense, and now is extended to now we have seen that the boom of internet for everyone. Same thing happening with the space industry. Space industry is open for everyone. The stage is ready for the upcoming industry. So before I go, I just want to share with you the three things what I learned from my experience. Number one, always respect the opportunity, no matter whether it's small or big. Number two is that if you believe in your dream, if you believe in your voice, if you believe in your idea, one day the world will believe in you. And the third one is that see the things differently, make it simple, dream big and never give up. Thank you.